Hi guys, I'm back with a new video. And this video is about brew magic. And I was asked to do a video about brew magic by several people, so it's about time that I do this video. When we think about witches, we see them flying around in front of a full moon on a broom, which is fine, but that's not how we fly. We choose to be here or there based on skill and willpower. Now, I used to use a lot of astral travel, but that's quite of a hassle and it takes a lot of dedication and it's a skill. You have to take your time to get this thing going and you have to be able to really ground your body to the bed or a chair or a couch or whatever, and then change your vibration so your etheric body can lift itself up from your body and you can go wherever you want to go. But like I said, it's a skill that takes a lot of time and a little bit of talent and dedication and focus and stuff like that. And it's like telekinesis. Some can do it, some can't do it, and some are just not into the whole spending years of training to get this done. Astral projection is for the lazy witch, I think, but very easy, very simple, very uncomplicated. You just astral project from one place to another. You think yourself from being here to being there. It has a lot to do with Silva and remote viewing and interest, remote viewing and influencing, and it's quite easy. Like I said, it's for the lazy witch. For example, I have three friends in the USA that I love very, very much, and I like to check up on them to see or feel or hear how they are doing. So I can touch them with my astral double, astral projection, and see if there's some kind of issue in their auric field or if their knees are still hurting or something else. Or I can feel whether or not they are sad or anxious or worried about something, and then I can relax them and help them and guide them and things like that. But remote viewing and remote influencing is something that can be used to do all kinds of beautiful things. Heal people, cherish people, hug people, heal people, relax people, things like that, calm people down or encourage them, things like that. But you can also do an insane amount of damage using astral projection. So the broom is more a symbolic thing for a witch that helps him or her focus on, I'm here and I want to go there. That's one thing about broom magic. You can just hold it, sit on the couch, relax, breathe, go into alpha and choose to do astral travel or astral projection. It's a tool. That's it. You don't need it, but if it helps you, then please do. Another thing is that I have been making brooms for as long as I can remember. I was able to ride a bicycle. I'm Dutch. That's what we do. We love our bikes and we bike as much as possible. I think everybody in the Netherlands has at least two bikes, so that says a lot. But that's not what I was going for. I learned how to ride a bike when I was 3. I'm 47 now, so I have 44 years of biking under my belt. But brooms, I love brooms. The silly thing is that I have a little broom and I can't find it anymore. I think it's hidden behind the dog snacks for Chica, so I can't show it to you. I think it's there, but I'm not really sure. Of course, I can use remote viewing to see where it is or douse on it, but I just want to do this video and upload it and for you to can, so you can see it. When you use a broom, it has a lot to do with Wicca nowadays, where you have to make a circle and things like that. Old-fashioned, old-school witchcraft uses circles, but not in a Wicca kind of way. So if you want something Wicca-ish, I'm not your witch. But the thing is, if I am in the attic or somewhere else doing astral projection or astral travel or going into alpha or do a ritual or an initiation or something like that, this is the movement I make to clear the space. That's it. If you are just starting with witchcraft and you're a little bit of a late bloomer and you didn't start as early as I did at age, I don't know, 3, 4, 5, then I suggest you make a broom. And I think birch is the best tree ever. It's a very aggressive kind of tree, but when you, once you have made a connection with a birch tree, then you can count on that tree for the rest of your life. So birch, like I said, it's an aggressive tree, but if you feel a connection and you can bond with this tree, you might have access, or the birch tree will allow you to use some bundles of these branches or sticks or whatever. So first you need a stick. Again, my first choice would be birch, and these birch, just look up the tree. It's a beautiful tree, and these branches sort of hang down, and you can sort of gently slice it off only when you have permission from that tree. If not, I wouldn't mess with birch tree, but because sooner or later he or she will astrally project itself to you and take revenge and sort of eat you alive, sort of suck out the life out of you. So don't mess with birch trees, especially when they are in a group. Second choice is hazel, especially the curled ones. These are quite beautiful. It might look a little bit strange if you have a stick with a swirl into it and then you use the smaller branches, the ends of it, and you cut them off. And but hazel is a very good one. It can be helpful in strangling your enemies, but also in making a kind of spider web thing that catches all the things you might need in your witchcraft and magic. Then there is something like willow, and of course these branches drop down in even water and things like that. But if you want to use a stick, I suggest you combine a beech or birch stick with the willow end. So you have a, I don't even have an example here. It's weird. I have this obsession with trees and brooms for as long as I can remember, but now I'm sort of, well, if this is your stick, then you need to attach with a rope these things so you can really make a swipe kind of movement. With a broom, it's the same with a wand. A wand, you can point at something and make things go away. or enchant them or charge them or whatever you want to call it. You can also use a wand to point at something and pull it inwards. Now, if I sense that something or somebody is watching me, I make this movement, sunwise. And if I want something in my circle, it's very rare that I create a circle, an invisibility circle maybe sometimes, but it's a Wicca thing, I think, most of the time. When I want to invite something, I focus with my mind on what it is I want to invite, and then I go moonwise. Sunrise, out of it, moonwise, into it. So when I work with certain demons or entities and I want to invite them in, it's like, come on in. And if you want some things to chase away, then you focus on what it is you want to chase away, and or you have your intuition tells you that something's blocking you and wants to harass you or attack you or bother you or annoy you or something, then just do this. I'm not going to go all the way round. It's like I know I'm in a cone, or I know I'm in a circle, and I know how big it is. So first you want to visualize your sacred space. Then you want to visualize how much space you need and how big it has to be. And then you're going to see if you want to place yourself in a cone or in a circle. That's another thing, but basically we're talking circles here, out, in. So if you feel there's angels around you or an elemental or something, you can invite them in if your intuition or your gut tells you that it's helpful in the ritual you're going to do, or even when you're just going to do some meditation, it might be nice to invite some angels or demons or chase other things away. There's another thing, a lot of witches, especially in Wicca, they think the athame or the stick or the broom or broom or whatever, the chalice or something, is something that you only use for rituals. Now, I am an old school, old fashioned, really basic witch, so I don't give a shit. I had a couple of brooms from Turkey. I love that country. I've mentioned this before. It's a lovely country. I had Turkish neighbors here in the Netherlands, and they used a straw broom. They just went to some kind of canal or a pond or something, and they would cut off these leaves that came out of the water, and they dried them upside down, and they did everything with it, and even magic. So if they want to chase the evil eye away from their child's bedroom, they would use this broom. If they would clean their balcony, they would use the same broom. And so I was like, finally, people with some common sense, some normality, some practical mindset. So I am one of those witches that uses a broom for about everything. Chasing away spider webs or an ant, or just get rid of some cat hair or something, or get rid of an entity I don't feel interested in, or if I'm feeling that somebody's watching me via astral projection or astral travel or whatever, then I am just going to use the broom, which I sort of lost because I got used to making this movement, and I make it all around, but I'm too lazy to walk in a circle. So I'm just going to mentally make the decision that this is the space I need, this is what I'm going to do, this is what I invite in, and this is what I want to get rid of, and then I'm going to do whatever it is I want to do. So I hope this is enough. Like I said, if you're a Wiccan, then I suggest you stick to things like an ethemy or a staff or a broom or a chalice or whatever you want to use, candles or... and do it the Wicca way. In my case, I'm just a witch. So if I feel the need to use an ethemy, then I'm too lazy to get it out of my closet and I just use a kitchen knife, which I also use to make some nice soup, chicken soup today. So it's your intention. And I think that magical items have a certain way to, but I mean, seriously, if I want to use a kitchen knife with an entity attached to it and it tastes good, then why not, right? So same with the broom. I love rooms, I really love them. I'm so sorry that I can't find my little tiny, it's this big. My daughter made it, it's awfully cute. And because of its cuteness, I sort of protected it and put it away because I don't want to use it, because when I use it, it will get dirty and broken and things like that. So just step into the world and enjoy. See you next time. Bye.